man himself, Huge Groove. Welcome back to Louisville, Kentucky.
Welcome back. It's my first time playing here. It's huge, yeah.
Well, you know, I thought you had been here before.
I've been here with Tina Turner. I've played here before and some other artists, but this is my first time as Huge Groove, yeah.
Okay, as your individual solo artist.
Yes.
Now tell me, you know, I had to Google you, and I saw your bio on everything, but share with the audience how you really got started and just how you took off.
Man, you know, I started playing sax when I was like 10 years old, so I've always done that. I knew I wanted to be a professional musician, which I thought was playing in the school band the rest of my life at 10. You know, you're not really thinking that far ahead. And just one thing led to another. I went to a great school in Florida, the University of Miami, and I was a classical saxophone major, and then I discovered guys like Junior Walker and King Curtis and David Sanborn, and I said, that's what I want to do, you know. And I just got more into that, and one band would lead to the next band and one door to the next, and I had an amazing sideman career. Again, talking to people like Tina Turner and Joe Cocker and Richard Marx, Tower of Power. And then I just felt like I wanted to do something as a solo artist about 10 or so years ago. So my first album came out in 2000. And just very lucky, very blessed.
Now, why smooth jazz versus some other type of art form?
I can't sing. So, you know, the saxophone was my voice. And I think it just fit into that. You know, easily, I always liked the R&B flavored music anyway, and that's what I kind of grew up listening to. I grew up in Maryland and a suburb of D.C., and I was hearing these great R&B stations from down there, and, you know, in the mid-70s, listening to people like Angela Bofill and, of course, Earth, Wind & Fire, and groups like that, and I think that's what kind of shaped my ears, you know, and so it was kind of a logical transition to, you know, be able to write songs that were in that old 70s R&B fashion and put the sax into it.
Is there anybody that you haven't played with that you would like to say, you know, this is someone I'd like to do a duo with or do something like that?
Man, there's lots of people I can sit back and dream about. You know, I mean, you know, I had the pleasure of with Tower of Power of backing up Al Green one time, and I'd love to do some kind of collaboration with him. You know, I think that would be a fun one.
So what's next?
So if you know him, you know, reach out, please.
I'll give him a call this afternoon.
Would you? All right. Would you? Yes, yes.
So what's next?
Next, I'm home for a few days, then I go to New York City next weekend. I'm playing with Richard Elliott back there, and I'm out every weekend between now and November, so it's a crazy busy year, thank God. Knock on brick or wood or whatever, but it's going to be a good year, so I'm excited.
One last question. You know, when I listen to your music, it's music that I love to listen to, and what's your inspiration? What gets you going? What's to get those creative juices going for you?
Yeah, I mean, it's a variety of things. Sometimes it's fear. You know, sometimes it's like I have a deadline that's coming up and I got to get it done. So, you know, I have to force myself and lock myself in the studio to get creative. Sometimes it can just be a good mood that day, or sometimes I can hear a song will come on the radio and it'll inspire me to like, man, that's so good. I got to write something good, you know. And so it comes from different places.
But does the name come first? And then the music, or does the music, how do the two match up?
Yeah, in fact, you know, the band here today, they were getting my charts, and they were mad. I said, what is 7.3? And I said, well, that's my seventh album, the third song I wrote for it. So I had, like, the working title still on the charts. So I don't really name them until afterwards, until I see the whole group of work come together, and then I can kind of get a feel of what it's about, you know.
Well, I really appreciate you spending some time with Urban Lifestyles, and I'm looking forward to hearing you play tonight.
Thank you. Thanks for coming out, guys.
Be all right. Do you feel it now?
Woo!